With a career spanning 70 years, the icy blonde beauty wasn't just an Alfred Hitchcock favorite. She also had a star-making role in one of the greatest American films of all time that hit screens 70 years ago, On the Waterfront, a movie that introduced Eva Marie Saint to the world. Yet for all this acclaim, Saint's life has also been full of heartache, tragedy, and memorable times that the living legend should be remembered for. Before we begin, make sure you watch this video to the end, smash the red button below this video to subscribe, and the bell button to get notified of our new videos. Born July 4th, 1924, Eva Marie Saint is an American actress best known for starring in 1954 Elia Kazan's On the Waterfront and in 1959 Alfred Hitchcock's North by Northwest. But before the accolade, Saint was born in Newark, New Jersey to Quaker parents, Eva Marie Nee Rice and John Merlay Saint. She attended Bethlehem Central High School in Delmar, New York, near Albany, graduating in 1942. She was inducted into the high school's Hall of Fame in 2006. She studied acting at Bowling Green State University and joined Delta Gamma Sorority. During this time, she played the lead role in a production of Personal Appearance. A theater on Bowling Green's campus is named after her. She was an active member in the theater honorary fraternity Theta Alpha Pi, and served as record keeper of the student council in 1944. Growing up, the classic actress had an adorable nickname in her high school yearbook that listed her as Bubbles, a name she earned when she was a child because she'd make bubbles in her mouth. The nickname stuck with her all through high school, with the actress finally shedding the name before she left for college. I want to be a teacher. While Eva Marie Saint became a household name in the movie industry, acting wasn't Saint's original ambition. The young, compassionate girl originally wanted to be a teacher. She was actually in the middle of majoring in education when a drama professor asked her to try out for a play. She got the role and loved the experience so much that she decided to change her major to drama. The rest, as they say, is history. Career. Saint got her start in show business working as a page or intern for the television studio NBC. At 19, it was her first job out of school, and it changed her life. According to Saint, the experience brought her out of her shell and gave her the opportunity to meet stars like Joan Crawford, whose brief words to her one day were, as she describes, the thrill of her summer. Moving on, she appeared in the live NBC TV show Campus Hoopla in 1946 to 1947. Her performances on this program are recorded on rare kinescope, and audio recordings of these telecasts are preserved in the Library of Congress. She also appeared in the Bonnie Maid's Versatile Varieties on NBC in 1949 as one of the original singing Bonnie Maids used in the live commercials. Facing rejection. Saint's first job on television wasn't actually an acting job. It was far more humiliating than that. Her job was to applaud the acts, first off-screen and then on-screen for $15. This wasn't exactly a prestigious role or even a Hollywood-sized paycheck, but it allowed her to buy a new dress, and that was good enough for Eva to begin with. Going on into her acting role, Saint experienced brutal rejection in the very infancy of her career. Just as she was about to perform on opening night, the director gave her crushing news. She was being replaced because the production was nervous with you. Saint was utterly devastated. After that, she made up her mind never to let the professionals get to her heart, so she'd be better able to handle it when rejection happened. Rise to stardom. Saint finally got her break and burst onto the Hollywood scene with On the Waterfront, the classic 1954 film starring Marlon Brando and directed by Elia Kazan, a performance for which she won the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress, which is no small feat. Her performance in the role of Edie Doyle, whose brother's death sets the film's drama in motion, which she won over such leading contenders as Claire Trevor, Nina Foch, Katie Jurado, and Jan Sterling, also earned her a British Academy of Film and Television Award nomination for Most Promising Newcomer. The film was a major success and launched Saint's movie career, She received $7,500 for the role. Astonishingly, it was Saint's very first film, but her debut absolutely knocked it out of the park. On the Waterfront famously stars Marlon Brando as the brooding, grieving dock worker. The legendary actor, however, was also legendarily difficult on set. But that didn't scare Eva Marie Saint. As she once explained firmly, "I've never been intimidated by other actors because I'm an actor." To her, the tempestuous Brando was just another co-worker. Mid-career, North by Northwest. When famed director Alfred Hitchcock was choosing roles for his new movie North by Northwest, he stunned everyone when he chose the still relatively untried Saint to play the role of the femme fatale in what was to become a suspense classic, North by Northwest 1959, with Hollywood heavyweights Cary Grant and James Mason beating out dozens of hopeful actresses. North by Northwest became a box office hit and an influence on spy films for decades. The film ranks number 40 on the American Film Institute's list of the 100 greatest American movies of all time. The Hitchcock Blonde. At the time of the film's production, much publicity was gained by Hitchcock's decision to cut Saint's waist-length blonde hair for the first time in her career. Hitchcock explained at the time, "Short hair gives Eva a more exotic look, in keeping with her role of the glamorous woman of my story. I wanted her dressed like a kept woman, smart, simple, subtle, and quiet. In other words, anything but the bangles and beads type." The director also worked with Saints to make her voice lower and huskier, and personally chose costumes for her during a shopping trip to Bergdorf Goodman in New York City. The change in Saint's screen persona, coupled with her adroit performance as a seductive woman of mystery who keeps Cary Grant and the audience off balance, was widely heralded. In 2000, recalling her experience making the picture with Cary Grant and Hitchcock, Saint said, "Grant would say, 'See, Eva Marie, you don't have to cry in a movie to have a good time. Just kick up your heels and have fun.'" Hitchcock said, "I don't want you to do a sink-to-sink movie again ever. You've done these black and white movies like On the Waterfront. It's drab in that tenement house. Women go to the movies and they've just left the sink at home. They don't want to see you at the sink." And I said, "I can't promise you that, Hitch, because I love those dramas." Personal life. Although North by Northwest might have propelled her to the top ranks of stardom, Saint chose to limit her film work in order to spend more time with her husband since 1951, director Jeffrey Hayden, and their two children. Saint married producer and director Jeffrey Hayden on October 28, 1951. They had two children together, Daryl Hayden and Lorette Hayden. Their first child, Daryl, was born 2 days after she won an Academy Award for On the Waterfront. They were married for 65 years until Hayden's death on December 24, 2016, at the age of 90. Saint returned to the big screen for the first time in over a decade in 1986, Nothing in Common, in which she played the mother of Tom Hanks's character. It was directed by Gary Marshall. Critics applauded her return to features. Upon the death of Olivia de Havilland in 2020, she became the oldest living and earliest surviving Academy Award winner, and one of the last surviving stars of the golden age of Hollywood cinema. Find this video interesting? Let's hear those thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to smash the subscribe button for more interesting videos.